on you. Captain's at the helm.
Clues down! Catch some wind! Four tops loose! Tops! Gallants! Royals! Studs!
Dark skies and rough seas there!
There's a man afloat there, sir! Shrink in the
earth! Lovage!
Sir! There's loot floating here!
Captain, looks bad!
Johnny Bunker, come rock and roll me over. To me, Johnny Bunker, do. Oh, to me, Johnny Bunker, the skip on is a rover. To me, Johnny Bunker, do. Oh, to me, Johnny Bunker, the mate he's never sober.
He's off the wind! All in all, sir!
All down and crew up! Furl those men!
Thank you. Here's to our pirate republic, lads. We're prosperous, free, and out the reach of kings, clergy, and debt collectors.
Near 500 men now pledge their allegiance to the Brethren of the Coast in Nassau. Not a bad number.
True. Yet we lack sturdy defenses. If the king were to attack the town, he'd trample us.
Then let us find the observatory. If it does what these Templars claim, we'll be unbeatable.
Not that twaddle again, can we? It's a story for schoolboys. I mean, proper defenses. Steal a galleon, shift all the guns to one side. We'll make a nice ornament for one of our harbors.
It will not be easy to steal a full Spanish galleon. Have you one in mind?
I do, sir. Then I'll show you. She's a fussock, she is. Fat and slow.
That's booty.
Thank you. That door handles nice. Pinched her from the Spanish, was it?
Aye. In the midst of a hurricane.
Just before the treasure fleet was smashed against the shore.
Was the haul aboard as rich as men are saying?
1,000 times that. I reckon £1,000,000 worth of reals was sunk that day.
Devil, love, hurricane. We'll have a dive there one day. See what we can rummage up.
Diving them wrecks would be a nice change of pace for us. No need for violent actions against merchants and such.
Well, that's some soft talk coming from a pirate. And as it happens, I mostly agree. We'll save the clashing of cutlasses for the military. And them that get in our way. She goes. No telling what you may find out here.
Like staring through a waterfall.
Don't soil your breeches, lads. I got this.
All under there, Captain! Hostile warship closing! Schooner by the rigging! Spaniards! Seems to be alone, sir!
I think we've lost them, sir.
Reef in, all top!
Found it all on, lads!
There it is.
That ship's a monster, look at the size of her.
Aye. And we'd not last long face to face with her. Hear that, Kenway? Keep your distance. We'll strike when fortune favors us.
Under cover of darkness, most likely.
Aye, it may come of that.
Dark skies and rough seas there!
Douse the royals, come!
Ground on every inch of sail!
Making for us, sir. It's a brig. Their ancients are Spanish. That's the low ship, Cap.
I think we're clear.
Trunks. I'd not haze you.
More sail! All sail!
wrath!
I would say the danger...
Close up! Eat her sticks! The yards off the wind!
Bring it all, sir! Calm and tight!
Mains out! Let's go!
Lay aloft on the fore! Come on!
Charles, as reckless as they come.
An old friend of yours?
Not a man I call a friend. But we've been doing this kind of work for so long, I can't help but respect the man. Slinking off with his tail between his legs. That's good news for us. Bleeding bastards! We'll have to deal with this skirmish fast. Forget the galleon and send these interlopers to hell!
For trouble blowing in! Then
fire!
Spanish enjoy! Hold them once, sir!
Ready to fire?
Fire!
Keep this right there, Kevin! Hostile warship coming at us! Cutter, sir! Spaniards! They've got help!
It is firing!
Shorten sail! Tear up the squall!
Get the mainsail into the wind!
Got us that tight!
Thank you.
Standing order!
Fire!
Take a shot! Right there, sir!
She's sailing for that island.
I know the place. Natural stronghold used by a French captain named Ducasse.
Julian Ducasse, the Templar.
Name's right. Didn't know he had a title.
I know the man. And if he sees my ship, he'll know it from his time in Havana, meaning he may wonder at who's sailing her now. I can't risk that.
And I don't want to lose that galleon. Let's think on it. And maybe wait till it's dark before hopping aboard.
Captain's trip.
Loose main sails!
Main's loose! Do you hear the news?
All sails! You'll take it!
Crowd on all the sail we have!
Fair to the starboard! Floating booty there for the taking, sir!
Trim the yards off the wind!
Reef the foremen!
Every last scrap of duck on the wind!
Clues down! Man your sheets!
That's a pirate, Hunter!
Stand up! Let's get moving!
Stunsels! Let's ride the squall!
Larboard, Captain! Cast away! Still alive, I think!
The mortar will...
Hold on!
upgrading the ship.
Right!
We're going to hit them
ahead!
Get the mainsails into the wind!
Hey! Well, he's all party like away we'll go.
Wave to the air.
Well, heave him up and away we'll go.
We're all bound on the land.
Floating booty there for the taking, sir.
Ease off the wind.
Wave to the
air. Off the wind, my boys. Well,
that
ease her.
Is where the cocks do crow.
We're all bound on the land.
And if we drown while we are young,
wave to the air.
It's better to drown than to wait to be hung.
We're all bound over the mountain.
Hey. Grow ye may, but go ye must.
Wave to the air.
Rope wave to larboard.
The head del bust.
We're all bound over the mountain.
Up socks you cocks, and her two blocks.
Wave to the air.
And go below to your old dicky box.
Liverpool town.
Goodbye, fare ye well. Goodbye, fare ye well.
mates.
Goodbye, fare ye well.
Douse those gallants! Haul!
Haul! Haul! Men do wait.
Tops! Gallants! Wild!
And
start!
To the other well, hear them say.
Goodbye, fare ye well. Goodbye, fare ye well.
Oh, here he comes, Johnny, with what he must pay.
Hurrah, ye boys!
My gals in will ring the old bell.
Goodbye, fare ye well. Goodbye, fare ye well.
And with him to his will raise merry yell.
Hurrah, ye boys, we're homeward bound.
We're homeward bound to the gals or the town.
Goodbye, fare ye well. Goodbye, fare ye well.
And step me your bullies and even all round.
Hurrah!
We get home, boys.
Gentlemen, as is custom among our kind, we do not plunge headlong into folly on the orders of a single madman, but act according to our own collective madness. The object of our attention is a square-rigged galleon, and we want her for the advantage she'll bring Nassau. So I'll put it to the vote. All those in favor of storming this cove and taking this ship, stomp and shout aye!
Aye!
Those who oppose, whimper nay!
Never was the King's Council so unified.
Thank you.
Thank you. Ugh. before dawn! Before dawn.
You remember the gift you gave me? Well, it answers just fine.
Fist of Putain! As bold as a musket ball, and still half as sharp.
I'm sorry about this, mate. But I can't risk you telling your Templar friends about me still kicking around.
I pity you, Bukenyi. After all you have seen, after all we showed you of our order, still you embrace the life of an ignorant and aimless rogue!
What's this?
Is petty larceny the extent of your ambition? Have you no mind to comprehend the scope of ours? All the empires on Earth abolished, a free and open world, without parasites like you! Que l'enfer que tu trouveras soit le fruit de ton insouciance.
The cove is ours!
I just saw you were logging out, so I thought I'd stop by and give you something. A little welcome gift. We give awards to our top-notch employees for doing quality work. And they're nice to have, since there's no official bonus scheme here. I already have about 11 or so. Oh. Bonjour. Of course. I'll pass it on. Well, looks like Olivier wants to meet with you. It's exciting. Follow me. It's on the top floor, so it's not hard to find. But the rest of this building can be confusing to first-timers, so we had the tools team whip up a great map application. Check your communicator. I added a waypoint to Olivier's office. Should be easy to find. Olivier's a nice guy. He won't bite.
Thank you.
thing working? This is John from IT. We met earlier. I was calibrating your animus. I'm sort of the Scotty of this Abstergo Enterprise, in charge of all the techie stuff. Do you have a minute? Oh, damn it. The tracker says you're on your way to Olivier's office. Ah, all right. I'll ping you when you're done. I have a favor to ask.
Bonjour. Go right in. He's waiting for you.
Well, unless you are specifically ordering me to abandon it, I won't jeopardize our flagship project. Edward Kenway is the... But this is how Hollywood got its start, right? With pirate movies. Douglas Fairbanks, Errol Flynn, and now we have access to the real deal. Wait. Exactly. We'll talk about all that together at the shareholders' event. Right. Looking forward to seeing you too. Take care, Letizia. Salut! Hi! Thanks for coming in. I know you're busy. So, I reviewed some of your data. Pretty raw stuff. Obviously, we need to scrub off some of the dirt to make it family-friendly. Maybe give Edward a voice like James Bond or something. More of a ladies' man. A beautiful city, no? So the main reason I asked you here concerns something called the observatory. It's been mentioned a few times in the footage you found. I'd like to encourage you to focus on locating this specific set of memories as soon as possible. If it were up to me, on s'en acquérisse. I wouldn't bother. But some bigwigs at Abstergo Industries have been hounding me for days. So, follow whatever leads you find, and hopefully we can... Oh, incoming call. I have to take this. We'll keep in touch. Bonne journée. Alan, bonjour.
Oui, tout va bien. Naturellement.
Oui, bien sûr. Quoi?
Hi, John from IT again. You got a second? Good. I'm adding a waypoint to your map. So, a colleague of yours left for vacation this morning and forgot to send a video file she promised me. Since I hate just about everyone else on your floor, I was hoping you could help me. Could you transfer the file from her computer and deliver it to the courier when she comes? It'll be easy. You just wander over to their animus, log in, and transfer the file. Easy. And please be snappy before I find a reason to hate you too.
It's not 30 degrees at one end of the building and 5 at the other.
A locked door. Not a problem. That's the advantage of me having level 1 security clearance. Now, you do too. Don't abuse it. Log on and I'll walk you through this. Section in your communicator, and you'll be redirected right away. Everything you download will be found in there, protected by a firewall, of course.
December 23rd, 2012. Sample Recovery Unit Team Lead Fisher Case reporting on Subject 17, Desmond Miles. The subject was deceased and unattended. Time of death was placed around 0:00 hours and 7 minutes, with conditions favorable for DNA sample recovery. We had some initial concerns about interference in the vault, but given the skill and talent of this team, we were able to capture useful data. I personally retrieved the subject's backpack and extracted a number of objects of interest to undergo detailed analysis. The subject displayed burns to the right hand, severe enough to fuse the bones, indicating some kind of spontaneous, intense burn trauma. Honestly, we've never seen anything like it before. Head, neck, and torso remained in good condition. I hand-selected recovery agents to retrieve fluid samples, blood and saliva. We then commenced material extraction and were able to preserve several exemplary samples. Data analysis and sequencing is already underway and, I'm told, proceeding with exceptional ease. Thanks to the cloud database and the work of Abstergo Sample Recovery Unit 3, the legacy of Subject 17 will continue uninhibited as Sample 17.
Oh, you're better at this than I'd hoped. Now zip on down to the lobby, come on. See, that file you acquired? I wouldn't recommend watching it. I mean, ooh, you could. But it's unpleasant. So once you hand it off, just pretend this never happened, okay? Otherwise, you'll just go to bed feeling sad. Anyway, the courier should be waiting downstairs. She's been here a while. I suppose it goes without saying, just because you now know how to hack all your colleagues' computers, it doesn't mean you should. I mean, not every day, right? No, seriously, though, that's illegal, so don't be a dick. Unless that's your nature. a bit rude making the courier wait.
I have this memory of you, when I keep coming back to, and I always think about it when I'm working or just before going to bed, because it sort of calms me, I guess. I was 14, I think, and you were trying to teach me how to walk with a light step. Remember that? How to be mindful of how much noise I made when I moved around. Simple stuff. Stuff I understand now, but back then, I, gotta tell you, I thought you were just being an asshole. You told me you were gonna go up to your room and sit with your back to the door and read a book. And you wanted me to wait at least 15 minutes and then sneak up there and tap you on the shoulder without you knowing. I even remember the book you were reading at the time, the one by Captain Johnson. And you warned me that if you caught me, we'd have to start all over. Then you went upstairs. And I waited. I waited. I waited 4 hours before deciding to go up. And even then, it took me 20 minutes to get to the foot of the stairs. And another 30 to get up them. And then 10 to get down the hall. And there I was at the door and peeked into your room. And I was so hoping that you'd be asleep. But no. No, you were still reading. And I just about shit myself. But 10 minutes later, I was just 5 feet away from you. And that's when I remember setting my foot down, and you flinched. Ever so slightly, you flinched. I thought maybe I'd imagined it.
Up, you know? This job is well below my skill level.
Yeah, well, your coffee is shit. You could use some practice.
What? No. I followed that recipe to the letter.
It's an art, Sean, not a science.
Oh, look who's here. So you didn't forget, after all. You're just incredibly rude. And made poor Rebecca here wait for nearly 30 minutes.
You limey, be nice. Sorry about him, he's high on his own supply. So, how should we do this? Data transfer? Great, that should do it. We'll email you the receipt. Till next time, take care, Sean.
Bye-bye, yes, bye. And don't expect any more free coffee. Arrogant. She's great, isn't she?
Hey, I just got word the courier has come and gone. Wonderful, you're a miracle. No, let's make the... You're not a miracle. You're an employee. Doing a job. But thanks for helping out. Anyway, thanks. Have fun pirating.
Cautious. They've made progress on that front, but there's a...
Assistance au niveau 2, projet échantillon 17. Support to the second floor, sample 17 project.
Security programs constantly monitoring the data flow. You need to sneak past them or they will destroy your data and send it back home.
Why did you take it? Who made you take it?
I took it of my own free will, with no constraint. I prefer a man's dress to a woman's.
It's been a few weeks since the last recording. Sorry about that. Of course, I guess it's just a few seconds for you. A leap down the playlist. I was talking about Clay. Kazmarek, Subject 16. So, when I fell into a coma back in Italy and woke up in the Animus Black Room, it was so calming. It felt like I had woken up into a dream, a haze, a dream where none of this mess had ever happened. Felt like I should just be getting ready for another day of pouring drinks at bad weather, and another day of complaining about being between girlfriends.
Oi. Where you going, the market?
No,
My parents have asked me to come live with them, and I'd like to.
Oh, what do you mean, live with them? You live here with me.
I'm sorry, Edward, but my father is right. You had a decent wage when you worked the farm. Why can you not be satisfied with that? With me?
Decent wage? That job was near as, damn it, to robbery. You want to be married to a peasant the whole of your life?
All right, Edward. All right.
You leave now, Caroline. You'll never know what's coming to us. Caroline! Caroline!
Kid.
Wake up, Kemwe.
What's that about?
He left this morning with the galleon. As faith, we'll discover a good use for this old cove ourselves.
Aye, we'll make something of it in time. We could keep a fleet here if we like. With a bit of fixing up, it'd be a decent place to call home. Might even convince my wife to come one day.
You're married, are you?
In God's eyes, I am. She left me some time ago.
Even so, keep that fact hid away. Most of these pirates don't respect a man with higher commitments than rum and plunder.
Upon mine honor, let me know if you find anything.
Odd-looking things, aren't they? Old and weathered.
Is this what they call Mayan? Or is it Aztec?
Are you good with riddles, Edward? Puzzles and ponderings and the like.
No worse than the next man, why?
I think you've a natural gift for it. The way you think and work. The way you understand the world.
Well, I don't know about that. You're talking in riddles now and I don't understand a word.
Clamber on top of this thing here, will you? Help me solve something. Concentrate and focus all your senses. Look past shadow and sound. Deep into matter. Until you see and hear a kind of shimmering.
A shimmering?
You understand?
I think so. I've seen its like before. Glowing like moonlight on the ocean. Ah, right. I know this feeling. I have since I was a lad. It's like using every sense at once, isn't it? To see sounds and hear shapes. What a combination.
Every man and woman on this earth has in them a kind of intuition hidden deep away.
I've had this sense most of my life. Only I thought it was related in some way to my dreaming or the like.
Most never find it. Others, it takes years to tease out. But for a rare few, it comes as natural as breathing. What you feel is the light of life, of living things past and present, the residue of vitality. Come and gone. Any man's senses can be tuned well past what he's born with. If he tries. You are a gifted man, Edward.
has a strange look. Is it worth something?
Nothing you can spend. But if you find all of them, it'll lead to something grand.
How many?
A few dozen, I think. This way. I've something else to show you. I found something else just here. I think you'll take to this secret much faster.
Now this has the makings of a mystery.
It's good, isn't it? Only wait till you see what lies at the end. Here we are. What do you think?
I think Monsieur Ducasse was a man of many secrets.
Aye, and look here. A solid staircase leading God knows where. What do you suppose lies at the top?
From what I knew of Ducasse, I wouldn't be surprised to find eclectic instruments of torture and villainy. An Iron Maiden or a collection of thumbscrews.
Or a pair of anguish.
Not a nice way to kick off. But that is some damn fine gear.
Try the key you took from Ducasse.
That's one. Only four left.
Aye. It might be that these four Templars have them. See the names here? They've been sent to kill these four targets.
Hang me, that's the map I sold to Governor Torres in Havana. He said it marked the location of assassin encampments.
You think maybe you owe them a bit of warning, then? If you have any kind of heart beating in that chest.
Suppose I could. If it leads me to the four other keys.
Bad excuse is better than none at all.
Leaving already?
I think this cove suits you best, Edward. Better than that costume does.
Oh, come on now. We're pirates, kid. We take as we please and become who we like. Self-made men.
But that look ain't you. It's not who you are.
Who am I, then?
Hard to tell some days. All I know is you like dangerous prizes.
Like the observatory. I think you know more about that than you let on in NASA.
You noticed that, did you? Meet me at 20 degrees, 3 minutes latitude, just off the coast of Yucatan. I'll have something to show you there in a few weeks' time.
Sir, I've been needing coin to set up the shipyard, Captain. The faster I have the needful gold, the sooner our ships will rule the waves. What do you be needing today, then? Some bit of business, that.
Captain's home.
Captain, we found a trove of nautical maps and ledgers and the like, scattered about the village. You'll find them sorted in the captain's quarters of the Jackdaw. Quality stuff.
Nautical maps and ledgers? Might come in useful if we decide to build up a fleet of our own.
Exactly my thinking, Captain. Have a look for yourself and tell me what you think. course today, Captain. It's a fine day for any kind of mischief.
What's your feeling?
I'll make no secret of wanting to see the British brought to heel. If we can take their gold and put it to use ourselves, I'll be a happy man.
Spoken like a true Welshman, Ade.
And what's your aim?
Master Kidd hinted at a prize he was eager to show me down in Tulum. Quite some distance, mind, on the Yucatan Peninsula.
You trust him to play it fair?
I can't be sure. He has a way of picking away at my conscience that gives me pause. I should go see him soon.
So long as we take some prizes along the way, I'm sure the crew will understand. I'll set a course for Tulum.
Lovely on the foreyards, it's lovely down below, boys. She's lovely because she loves me, that's all I want to know, boys. Oh, Captain Baker, how do you store your cargo? Some I stow forward and some I stow...
Foresail!
Fathoms or more below, boys.
Oh, boys, oh, boys, oh.
40 fathoms or more below.
Larboard, Captain. Spider cast the drift here, Captain.
Oh, way high, and up she rises.
Oh, boys, oh, boys, oh.
Way high, and the blocks is different sizes. One more
pull,
don't you hear the mate a-ballin'?
Douse those gallants, pull!
One more pull, that's the end of our haulin'.
Fire!
Charlie Brown, she's the gal.
Ready to fire, sir! Hold sail, she'll take it! Sponsors out! Fire! Good shot, good crippler! Fire! 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 Fire, the fire, sir! Fire!
Fire! Fire! Fire! Fire! Ready to fire, sir!
Start!
Lose top to gallant the royals! Come! We'll need the
carpenter
to fix that!
Fire!
Off target! Do not let the ram us, Captain!
Swim the yards off the wind! Fire!
Let Captain Wolf play shot there!
Blew up! Blew up!
Hit her from a safe range with
fire!
Our...
It's
all exposed! To...
It is firing!
Who saved sail?
Douse the gallant to royals! Fire! Fire!
Not good enough!
Ground on every inch of sail!
Ready to fire, sir!
It is firing! Fire!
Keep out of her way!
She will brace yourself!
Taking a hit, Cap!
Fire!
Yeah!
Stop!
right here!
Captain, it's a fine day for any kind of mischief.
What's your feeling?
I'll make no secret of wanting to see the British brought to heel. If we can take their gold and put it to use ourselves, I'd be a happy man.
Spoken like a true Welshman, Addy.
And what's your aim?
Master Kidd hinted at a prize he was eager to show me down in Tulum. Quite some distance, mind, on the Yucatan Peninsula.
You trust him to play it fair?
I can't be sure. He has a way of picking away at my conscience that gives me pause. I should go see him soon.
So long as we take some prizes along the way, I'm sure the crew will understand. I'll set a course for Tulum.
Douse all but me! Wait for the day! Wait for the day! Douse all sail! crowded all on!
Nothing in the galley, nothing in the hole. Skipper's turned in with a bag of gold. And we're waiting for the day, waiting for the day, waiting for the day. Then we get off. Off of the nest, they sprang a leak. Near a poor old timber's creek. And we're waiting for the day, waiting for the day, waiting for the day.
We have looted some goods useful for upgrading the ship.
Get the mains free! Loose oil and trim sharp to the wind!
Crowd on all the sail we have!
And listen to me. I'll sink
to larboard, sir! Cast away! Still alive, I think!
Windy weather, boys, stormy weather, boys, welcome in close. We're all together, boys, blowy with west, blowy with west. Jolly sou'wester, boys, steady. Jumps the hay with a slippery tail, climbs up aloft and reefs the topsail. And it's windy weather, boys, stormy weather, boys, when the wind blows, we're all together, boys, though even west, though even low, jolly sou'wester, boys, steady she goes. And then up jumps the shark with his nine rows of teeth, saying, you eat the dough, boys, and I'll eat the beef. And it's windy weather, stormy weather, boys, when the wind blows, we're all together, boys, blowing in the west, blowing in the low, jolly sou'wester, boys, steady she goes, up jumps the whale, the largest
snow. Stop it, Captain! Did he loot float by
again? Wind, well, a blow, he's a squall. It's windy weather, boys, stormy.
Tread lightly! His waters are well guarded, sir!
Necesita algo.
Seguro que será provechoso para los dos.
¡Ahoy, Captain!